Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. We're about to go into this bear cave. Hopefully, we will have better luck against a bear than the bandity outlaw-y types that we found last time. Building the Warden's Lodge in your... Okay.
Got it.
Okay, we've got a goodie over there. Oh, and there's the bear. Can I just start right off with this? Did that do anything? I want to use that. Okay. You cannot venture forth while in combat. Okay. Not going there yet. Alright, this area is tough for us. We need party members. It's too bad that Dolan guy, whatever his name was, didn't join us. Okay, we can leave there. Maybe we should just leave. Those bandit outlaw types are over there, but let's go see what's around here. I know right after I said that and I'm not leaving. I wonder how you get to that Zorup camp. You can't go further than that. Let's at least fill out this part of the map. Come back when I actually have a party member or two to back me up. Sound like a good idea? This is the way to, what do you call it? Gilded Vale? So we need to go. Gilded Vale. The stealth skill is used to avoid detection while in scouting mode. Classes like rogues and rangers start with a bonus to stealth. Okay, quest updated. Gilded Vale is said to be one of the most prosperous villages in a Deerwood, full of opportunities for work and wealth. I was told they're offering land to new settlers. I finally reached Gilded Vale. It's not quite what I was expecting. Why not? It's a strange vision, so I can't explain. Hopefully I find answers here. Is this a friendly area? Should I be sneaking? There's something up there if I can get to it. No, looks like I have to be up there, don't I? What's that? Oh. Oh, wait. Oh, is there some kind of town meeting going on here? Oh no! They're hung, aren't they?
You must be one of the new settlers. Welcome to Gilded Vale. You'll be pleased to know that we've had some recent vacancies here.
A man approaches you, his skin as dull and gray as a desolate village behind him. He scans you with sunken, lifeless eyes. His voice is a dry croak. Doesn't exactly sound like a dry croak, but he glances at the gnarled, leafless monstrosity of a tree next to him. They are. They're hanging from the tree. I feel at home already. Do you welcome everyone this way? The only answer you hear is the buzzing of flies from the tree.
Of course, we'll need to make some inquiries first. The inestimable Lord Radric the Seventh has taken great pains to insulate our town from Widewind's legacy. Have you ever conceived a hollowborn child?
What's a hollowborn child? He appraises you over half-moon spectacles and scratches his chin. What are you talking about?
An infant born without a soul, of course. Lord Radric has made it his first priority to eliminate this scourge from our village.
We read about the godlike ones. I wonder if that's what they're talking about, the godlike.
I should warn you, stranger. Here in Gilded Vale, we have a special place for dissidents, charlatans, and those who would hide a curse in our midst.
He steps to the side and inclines his head ever so slightly toward the deformed tree.
His lordship's wife is with child and due any day now. Without his approval, I shan't be able to find you a permanent settlement. It will have to wait until after the birth. We can continue our interview then, after the bell tolls from Radric's hold to signal my lord's new heir. In the meantime, you can find temporary accommodations at the inn, just southwest of here.
Huh. I'm kind of skittish about telling him about the BOAC and the ceremony. I don't feel it's a good idea to ask him that, at least not yet. You said something about Hollowborn and Widewind's legacy before? He blinks. I forget that you foreigners do not have this curse in your homelands. The Hollowborn have been a scourge upon the Deerwood for almost 15 years now. He lowers his voice to a whisper. Children born without souls. He shakes his head. Pitiful, dumb things that breathe, barely, but do not truly live. Some say the Hollowborn are a disease. Some say they are a punishment from the gods. He raises his empty hands. In truth, no one knows, but they began spreading after the Saints' War, and so the name Widewind's Legacy stuck in honor of that foul, blasphemous pretender. His voice shakes with vitriol. I see. Lord Radric's decrees may seem strict at times, but he has our best interest at heart. Interests at heart, he nods. If you have any other questions, don't hesitate to ask. It's important that everyone in Gilded Vale understand our rules. I don't have a chance to ask about the tree again, but I guess that ties in with my other questions. Before I got here, I saw several people conducting a strange ceremony near some ruins. So I'm not sure about asking him this. I'm afraid he's going to become suspicious of me. He regards you carefully, see? You want to mind where you mention that. Trespassing on Ingwithin ruins is illegal, not to mention dangerous. You probably saw someone attempting some new ritual to appease the gods. People will try anything these days. Bereth have mercy. We certainly have. Maybe so. Like I said, it's best to stay away from those sorts of places. I've been feeling strange ever since a close call with the Biawak. Is there someone in town who could help?
Whatever your problem, it sounds like a matter for an animancer. However, the only animancer in Gilded Vale isn't in any condition to speak.
Okay, he's hanging from the tree.
Consider yourself fortunate. After she failed Lord Radric, we saw to it that she wouldn't profit from the misplaced trust of others. A bad cure is often worse than none at all.
Okay, now I really don't want to be here.
But if you're set on finding a bottle of troll piss or a dead Audra pebble to rub on your forehead, you're welcome to check her pockets. A little corpse stink is nothing when you're digging for shit.
Nice.
My advice, however, is to be satisfied that you escaped and leave it at that.
Well, goodbye.
Keep out of...
Listen!
Someone's ringing a church bell or something.
Two tolls. Let that be the last. Three. Gods have mercy.
Oh my god, it's the White Walkers.
It seems your arrival is ill-timed.
Urgeet looks out towards the east, his expression unreadable. He blinks slowly and turns his attention back to you. The reason I said that, guys, is from Game of Thrones when the horn is blared three times. I think twice is, what do you call it? Wildlings. Three times is, White Walkers.
Three bells toll only for the death of a Radric. I fear Lord Radric's heir is lost, or else Hollowborn, and so lost all the same. You should tread carefully. Circumstances have changed a great deal.
A peculiar spasm crosses his face, and the corner of his mouth quirks up into a mirthless smile. What do you mean? You come to us at a time of mourning. The legacy has struck at the heart of Gilded Vale. Our efforts to redeem ourselves in the eyes of Bereth must be redoubled. He sets a steady gaze on you. What happened? He shrugs one bony shoulder. I will know more details when the messengers arrive. The vagaries of childbirth, perhaps, but that is not your concern. Does this affect the Lord's offer to new settlers? I can be sure of nothing right now. I advise you to get some rest. The inn, or a stable for all I care. Find me afterwards. I will know more soon enough. Okay. Well, it doesn't make sense to tell him not to threaten us now. Even though he doesn't really care if we stay at a stable, he's such a sweet man. Farewell. I really don't want to fight all these guys. Anything more we can say to him? I gain experience. Urgent. I don't know how to say this name. Wears a twisted frown. I'm afraid I still can't help you find residence here. Lord Radric's son was deemed a Hollowborn. This makes circumstances even more fraught than before. How'd you find that out? Telepathy while you were just standing here? Tell me about Lord Radric. He comes from a line of nobles who have defended these lands since Aedir times. Radric II was an early supporter of Deerwooden independence during the Revolution, and the current Lord's father perished in the Saints' War. Hollowborn began appearing in the Deerwood shortly after the war's end. Lord Radric has taken it upon himself to purge the curse from Gilded Vale. His measures have been severe but necessary. Unfortunately, it may not have been enough if the bells were any indication. The Saints' War? Our age's most egregious example of man's madness. 15 years ago, the people of Red Saris decided that Widwin, their living saint, was the literal incarnation of the god Eothas. Urjet wrinkles his pinched nose. This supposed saint took it upon himself to liberate the Deerwood, supposedly from allegiances to less worthy gods, but I've never known an army to conquer a land for its people's own good. The war lasted about a year, but you can guess what that year did to the worship of Eothas in the Deerwood. Lord Radric's forebears had all been Eothasians, but after his father fell defending us from those fanatics, he personally saw that the Temple of Eothas here in town was shut down. He points at a few ruined walls near the tree. If you have any other questions, don't hesitate to ask, etc. I'd like to know more about Gilded Vale. We're a frontier village, as are most settlements in the Deerwood. Gilded Vale hasn't grown much since its establishment in the colonial days, and the last 15 years have seen our population shrink further. He takes in the ramshackle houses and half-fallen fences. Hence our recruitment of fresh settlers. Besides all this hanging from the tree, why has Gilded Vale's population been shrinking? Widwin's legacy, of course. Many women have had difficulty bearing healthy children of late. A few years ago, Lord Radric decreed that no mothers of Hollowborn are to be allowed in Gilded Vale. His mouth tightens into a firm line. His lordship dealt swiftly with the objectors. It may be harsh, but if it purges us of this curse, is it not worth it? Tell me about those ruins behind the tree. That's what's left of the Temple of Eothas. His lips pucker. Lord Radric forbade worship of the dead god after the Saints' War. It has been abandoned for almost 15 years, but there are plans to rededicate it to Barath, the god of life and death. You'll get to know the town well enough as you explore, I'm sure. Yes, yes, I'm sure. There's a sellsword. Speak to Urjit if you're in need of instruction. An archer? Keep out of trouble. Well, this isn't a friendly place that I thought that we'd find. What if it's not the baby? Maybe Kulsk managed to... Hush, are you mad? Leave it for indoors. I heard they fended off another attack on Lord Radric's keep. Did you hear the bells? Bad news, I think. Poor Afra is so worried about her child. I don't blame her. Been thinking about joining family over in Deerford. They have it far better than us. You'd think these rains would be a boon for the crops. The crops are blighted. The legacy is upon us. This place is cursed. Feels like we've been seeing more bandits along the roads of late. Okay, where is she going to get this? Oh, through here. Let's talk to Edder.
Were you looking for someone in that tree? I could introduce you.
Strange way to talk about your dad. He looks up at the tree and breathes out. Half the town's up there now, seems like. No right way to talk about it. I'm looking for someone who can help me feel better. That's a weird way to ask. He gives an understanding nod as he takes a long drag from his pipe. My condolences. He exhales and turns his attention away, watching the village around him. The man smiles broadly. Welcome to our lovely village. Scattered between the roots are bracelets of twine and bead, wilting flowers and notes half erased by the rains. More blood moss. That goes down there as a hole or something? Oh, hold on. More villagers. Things are bound to get worse now. Careful if you head east. Guards patrol the Estern Wood, but not the Black Meadow. Feels like you've been seeing more bandits along the road. I heard they fended off another attack on Lord Radric's keep. Can we pick these? Bear-ass spell? It's new, isn't it? This flowering plant has drooping flowers of a somber blue and gold shade. Both the sweet-smelling leaves and berries of the plant are known to be extremely poisonous, toxic to grazing animals and people alike. Great. So that leaves. Can we go in this? There's more people. Oh. Angry townsmen. A loth. You see four people gathered by the door to the inn. Their raised voices and chopping gestures suggest an argument reaching its climax. The first figure raises his hands for calm. His face is partially obscured by a hood, but his height and stature suggest an elf.
I meant no offense. Let's put this matter to rest over a round, shall we? My treat.
We're gonna end up helping this guy and fighting them, aren't we?
Hoping to soothe our pride with a few Adira coppers, eh? We don't need your coin.
The others, two folkmen and an elven woman, don't look convinced. The woman crosses her arms. She spits at his feet. Ooh, a fight. What's going on? One of the other men points at the hooded elf. His eyes are red from drink, but his gaze is focused. Mocking us even while he shelters in our village. Just goes to show you what these fancy Adir manners are worth. We don't take to that kind of treatment. Not from foreigners, especially not from Adirians.
Go on. Say it again. I'm itching for an excuse.
The second man thrusts his chin at the elf. He stinks of sour ale.
Why, you're itching for the kindling touch of your sister, you cocksfeather!
He wasn't talking like that before.
I'll cut that barrel-looking tongue out of your head!
A collective cry of outrage rises from the three locals.
This is a misunderstanding. I didn't say whatever it is you think I said. We've nigh quarrel.
Horror and shock paint themselves across the elven's man's face in broad, hasty strokes. He frowns and swallows. He plants his feet. Something surly and raw flickers through his eyes. Okay, is he bewitched, or he has a multiple personality disorder?
That's where you're wrong.
The elven woman draws a blade. This is unnecessary. Wouldn't you rather be inside drinking than out here arguing? We don't want your charity either, foreigner. They squint at you through red, bleary eyes. It sounds suspiciously like you're defending him. Yeah. Well, maybe we can have a party member if we fight him. Fight them. Is he an ally? I don't know. Can I use this? Soul shock. Well, that helps him. Oh, he's dead. Oh no, he's barely injured. Okay, never mind. Well, that was easy. As the last of the attackers falls, the elf turns to you, the tension almost gone from his smooth face.
Not quite how I hoped to get to know the neighbors. Thank you for your timely assistance with that awkward situation.
You mean for slaughtering them? You're welcome.
Well, that is one way of putting it.
Gives you a quick smile. He straightens his hood, and you note the remains of fraying embroidery on his gloves. His boots are caked with the dirt of many months' travel, but the leatherwork beneath it is sturdy and fine.
Well, I suppose introductions are in order after that little fiasco. Aloth Corvisor, at your service.
Tell me about yourself.
Well, I'm a wizard by training, and an adventurer by necessity. I was born in the Seathwood, part of the mainland of the Adir Empire, and both of my parents served the nobility, which afforded me an education for which I'm grateful. However, there were no open positions in those houses, and so I decided to seek new means in a new land.
I'm loving the voice acting in this game.
And how exactly did you come to be here?
I was traveling with a caravan, but we were separated near some ruins.
Inguithan ruins? Well, those can be dangerous places during the best of times, which these are not. And half the locals would arrest you for trespassing, and the rest would kill you outright. I'm curious, what exactly did you find there?
Several hooded figures operating a strange machine. Aloth goggles at you silently, apparently assessing your earnestness. Finally, he gives you a clipped, awkward laugh.
You do manage to find yourself in rather interesting predicaments.
Just how did you manage to cross those three drunks?
I'm afraid that was a matter of misunderstandings and mistranslations. It doesn't help that people in these parts remember their war with Adir like it was yesterday.
You did make a rather lewd suggestion regarding one of the aggressors and his own sister. Is that what he said? Ah, that. He clears his throat and adjusts his sleeves. As I tried to tell them, they misheard me. Happens all too easily after a few pints, and the accent doesn't help. I heard the same thing. For just a moment, he looks as if he's about to say something else. His expression brightens with mischief, but before he can speak, he forces a tight smile, biting his lips so hard you expect to see blood. Finally, his face relaxes and he shakes his head. I should speak more clearly next time. My apologies. Now, whatever's in him that says this, it was about to say it again, but he stopped it. What are you doing in Gilded Vale?
An excellent question. I came looking for fresh air and cheap land. Instead, the magistrate gave me directions to the inn and a story about the local lord's expectant wife. But I take it that's a familiar tale.
He cocks his head, looking at you. And you? Like you said, I'm also a settler.
Indeed. In that case, welcome to Gilded Vale, a true refuge from civilization.
His eyes flicker across you and your travel-worn clothing. You don't exactly look like a settler.
Begging your pardon, but neither do you.
True.
Yet, circumstances can find a person in the strangest of places.
I should get going.
An excellent question. I came looking for fresh air and cheap land. Instead, the magistrate gave me directions to the inn and a story about the local lord's expectant wife. But I take it that's a familiar tale.
Did I hit the wrong key? 4. I should get going.
As should I, given recent events. It's just as well. I've had enough of the watered wine and lumpy beds at the inn. They say even the owner tired of the place. Just up and left one day. It explains quite a lot about the upkeep. Perhaps I could join you. I could use a change of scenery, and I find it's better to travel in numbers.
Excellent, yes. I have some bandits. I have a score to settle with them. So do I. Let's go then.
Excellent. I shall follow you.
Yes, excellent, my dear chap. So he has a scepter. Scepters are the most imperious-looking magical implements and are often favored by Edirian wizards for this reason. Like wands and rods, they have flexible damage types. So he's a second level wizard, wood elf. Blast. These are his spells. Well, let's see what these guys have. A club. Most commonly fashioned from a short length of wood, clubs are simple, but fast and effective weapons. Simple clothing. This outfit is extremely simple, consisting of little more than a rough shirt and breeches made from uncomfortable material. And silver lust. Oh, silver. Oh. The most common Valian coin found in a deerwood, the silver lusk fish is so named for its resemblance to the scales of a fish. Now, was it all get transferred to what? Is that all copper? Angry townsmen. Oh, they're dead townsmen now. Copper skeet. The skeet is the standard currency used in the Aether Empire and the areas under their direct control. Like the deer wooden pan, it is a small copper coin. Well, finally have a party again. Oh wow, look at all these places we can go visit. The Black Hound Inn. Road west, road south. So we also got the Blackhammer Smithery, Ingroid's House, Windmill, and Rhodes. Okay. Thanks for watching. Tune in next time when we explore the Blackhound Inn. Thanks for watching as always, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.